What is up, everybody? Back with another list here, and it's going to be my 10 favorite hard rock guitarists of all time. I've done top 10 metal, top 10 glam metal, so now I'm getting around to my 10 favorite hard rock guitar players. Ton of great ones. I'm a big fan of like 70s hard rock, as I've said in the past, and if you've seen my videos before, you know who's number one and two already, but a lot of great players to pick from here. Finally got it narrowed down. We'll give some honorable mentions at the end as usual. Here we go. Starting off my list at number 10 is going to be Mark Kendall from Great White. Amazing player, fantastic tone. Great White, one of my favorite hard rock bands. The vocals are fantastic from Jack Russell, but a big part of what makes them stand out for me is this guitar playing from Mark Kendall. Really all of their albums from the debut in 1984, self-titled, which is a bit more on the metal side. Some of these guitar players are going to be on the border between metal and hard rock, of course, but other than that album, most of their stuff is like straight up bluesy hard rock. Amazing, amazing material here. Psycho City in 92 is great. Twice Shy in 89. Once Bitten in 87. So many great albums, a lot of great riffs, solos, songs from these guys. Mark Kendall, a freaking beast of a guitar player, so he has to make my list. Number 10. Next up at number 9 is Ace Frehley. He's best known as being the original lead guitarist of Kiss. He played on all of their stuff from the debut in 1974, up through Music from the Elder in 1981, was out of the band for a while, had his band Frehley's Comet in the late 80s, some solo stuff, came back to Kiss in about 96, was with them again until 2002, was on the Psycho Circus album in 98, so he's got a lot of great material to go through and listen to with him. 9 solo albums, including the Frehley's Comet stuff, 10 albums from Kiss he played on, and for me, a lot of that 70s Kiss stuff, maybe not a lot of it, but some of it would sound a little bit flat, kind of dry, until you get to the Ace Frehley guitar solo midway through the song or whatever, and just blistering fast, awesome stuff that saved the songs a lot of times. So great player, and of course he had a really cool image back then in the 70s, the Spaceman, my favorite member of Kiss easily back then, so gotta be on the list here. Number 9, Ace Frehley. Next up at number 8 is Ricky Medlock of Blackfoot and Lynyrd Skynyrd. He started with Blackfoot way back in 69, and then he was in Lynyrd Skynyrd 71, 72 as a drummer, and he also did vocals because he's the singer of Blackfoot as well. He was out of Lynyrd Skynyrd, wasn't in the plane crash or anything, but he came back to Skynyrd in 96. He's been with them again since 96, but Blackfoot is what, for me, I like the most of his stuff in. Debut album, No Reservations, in 75. Up through, I'd say, like 87, Rick Medlock and Blackfoot. A lot of great material there. Best albums, I'd say, are Strikes in 79 and probably Tom Catton in 1980. But again, all that stuff there from 75 to like 87, really good. A lot of great solos from Ricky Medlock. He's got a good voice as well. The solo in the song Highway Song, pretty legendary, kind of like a tribute to Lynyrd Skynyrd, I think. It's kind of a similar style to the Freebird solo. So really great, fast, awesome stuff there. Ricky Medlock, super underrated, great, great musician. Gotta be on my list, number 8.
You got a whole bunch of wages, and see that much of wages.
Coming in at number 7 is going to be John Sykes. Now, this is a guy that's kind of on the border between hard rock and metal again, but to me, more of a bluesy hard rock player for the most part. He did start off, his first like big band was Tigers of Pantang in the early 80s, a new wave of British heavy metal band. Then he was in Thin Lizzy for a while, or not really too long. He was just on one album, Thunder and Lightning in 83. Then he was in Whitesnake. He played on their self-titled album in 87. Monstrous, amazing guitar tone, especially on that album. And then, of course, he was the front man, the singer, the only guitarist in Blue Murder. Put out a couple of great albums, the debut self-titled specifically. Amazing, but great player. Some of them, you know, some great solos from him. Freaking Still the Night's amazing. The song Cold Sweat, that guitar solo is freaking legendary, but amazing player. Kind of a somewhat underrated guy. I was about to say overrated, but underrated player here, John Sykes. Doesn't get talked about too much, but fantastic guitarist. John Sykes, number 7. Coming in at number 6 is Rick Emmett of Triumph. Amazing underrated guitar player here. He's even a great singer. He kind of trades off on vocals with Gil Moore, the drummer. But for me, I think his voice is a lot better than Gil's voice. But that's just me. As far as his guitar playing goes, he does all the work. So all the riffs, all the guitar solos is him on these Triumph albums. And there's a lot of great ones. Looking at the albums here, they have a really great run of classic stuff from the debut self-titled in 76, Rock and Roll Machine, Just the Game in 79, which has probably their most famous song, Lay It on the Line. It's a great one. What else we got here? Progressions of Power in 1980 is a really good album. Allied Forces, Never Surrender, and Thunder 7, kind of like their classic run of albums up through 84. Surveillance in 87 I think is really great as well. There's a song on here called Headed for Nowhere, which that one, the guitar solo has always stood out to me as one of the best of his. The opening riff is amazing in that song as well, but all throughout the catalog, ton of great riffs and solos. Super underappreciated player here. You can look up their performance from the US Festival 83. He's on fire during that, but a lot of great stuff here. Rick Emmett, amazing player, number 6. Next up at number 5 is Jimmy Page, arguably the most influential guitarist on this list, but as far as favorites go, gotta put him at number 5. Been in a lot of projects through the years. Obviously, Led Zeppelin is what he's best known for. So many great songs, riffs, solos throughout Led Zeppelin. He was in the Yardbirds, Page and Plant, Coverdale Page, The Firm. But that Led Zeppelin material, a lot of legendary stuff. Go back to 1969, the debut album. A lot of good stuff on there, but Dazed and Confused, that guitar solo, kind of groundbreaking, maybe the fastest stuff at the time. It's got a nice slow build up and then just an explosion. That guitar solo is, it's really awesome. All throughout the catalog of Led Zeppelin, a lot of great riffs and solos. Another one that gives goosebumps every time has got to be the Stairway to Heaven solo. Yes, it's an overplayed song, but that guitar solo is freaking legendary and amazing. Just overall, Jimmy Page is a fantastic, classic, amazing guitarist. Got to be on anybody's list, I'd imagine. So he's at number 5 for me. Jimmy Page. Next up at number 4 is Michael Schenker, another guy that's been in a lot of bands. He's another guy also that is on the edge of hard rock and metal. Could consider him metal, but for now, gonna say he's hard rock. First album he was on was Lonesome Crow way back in 72, the first Scorpions album. He was like 15 or 16 when that was recorded, which is crazy, but my favorite material he plays on is when he was in UFO, that original run, because he came back a little bit later on, but the original run he was in for UFO, which was from 74, Phenomenon, up through Obsession in 78, those are the studio albums he was on there, and then he was on the Strangers in the Night live album in 79. You got Michael Schenker Group, Macaulay Schenker Group, a lot of material with this guy, and you know, his solos are just really fast, clean, just his sound is amazing. And again, kind of the same situation with Kiss sometimes. That 70s UFO stuff would sound a little eh, and then you get to the solo and it's just amazing. So he saved a lot of that stuff. He's the main reason I like UFO for sure. But amazing player, definitely deserves the recognition here. Michael Schenker, number four. Next up at number three is Ritchie Blackmore, another fantastic, classic, influential guitarist here. He's played on a lot of stuff, but of course, the Deep Purple and Rainbow material is what I enjoy the best. He was the original Deep Purple guitarist, so he was on everything from the debut up through like Stormbringer, I think, and then was out for a while, came back for Perfect Strangers and whatever else. Rainbow, primarily, I like the first three albums of theirs with Ronnie James Dio, but Ritchie, ton of great riffs and solos, great bluesy, hard rock type stuff here. Some people consider him metal, but to me, he's more of an influence on metal rather than actually being metal. Some legendary solos, Child in Time, Highway Star specifically, Rainbow, Long Live Rock and Roll is one of my favorite albums from the 70s. Of course, Rising is another great legendary album, but amazing player, number three, Ritchie Blackmore. Coming in at number two is Ted Nugent. Huge fan of Ted. For me, he's pretty much the total package. He has everything you could want. Showmanship, the great riffs, the great solos. He's got a good voice. He's got longevity. He started off back in the mid-60s with the Amboy Dukes, put out several really good albums with them. Solo stuff is legendary in my opinion. The self-titled debut in 1975. Some of the best rock songs of all time are on there, and specifically Stranglehold, I'd say, is the best rock song of all time. Free For All, freaking Cat Scratch Fever, Weekend Warriors, State of Shock, Scream Dream, Nugent, freaking all that stuff. Penetrator, even up through the 80s, I like when he kind of went more glam metal Nuge. Then you got Damn Yankees, freaking Come Again, one of the best guitar solos again of all time. Ted is a freaking monster, easily the biggest Rock and Roll Hall of Fame snub in my opinion. I've done several videos talking about that stuff, but for me, one of the best of all time, easily in my top two, Ted Nugent, number two. And before I get to number one, which is probably a pretty obvious one, but gotta give some honorable mentions here. Angus Young and Malcolm Young, both really good honorable mentions. Angus on lead, Malcolm on rhythm. Who else we got here? Frank Hannon from Tesla is, again, a guy on the edge of hard rock and metal, but a great player. Billy Gibbons from ZZ Top. Alex Lifeson from Rush, Alan Collins, who is from Lynyrd Skynyrd, the Freebird guitar solo alone gets him an honorable mention because that's amazing. Slash, Jimi Hendrix. I'm not the biggest Jimi Hendrix fan. I mean, I like Jimi Hendrix, but I think he's a tad overrated. Wouldn't say he's number one, like a lot of people always say, but deserving of an honorable mention for sure. I got Matthias Jabs on here for another honorable mention. He's the guy that's been the guitarist of, or lead guitarist of Scorpions for 40 or so years now. He's great as well. But, on to number one. And taking the number one spot, of course, has got to be Eddie Van Halen, the freaking master, extremely influential player to almost every rock and metal guitarist that came after him. Very innovative player. That finger-tapping guitar solo style that he does is incredible. The guitar tone he has, best of all time. When that first album came out in early 1978, blew everybody away. Nobody heard stuff like that before. Just the sheer power and speed of his playing. Was unmatched, still was unmatched all throughout the freaking career of Van Halen. But that first album, my favorite by them, Van Halen 2 is amazing as well, and Women and Children First, I'd say are all top 20 hard rock albums of all time. I'm the One, my favorite guitar, or my favorite song by Van Halen, but that guitar intro is amazing. Just blistering fast riff and solo. Ain't Talking About Love is another classic, iconic one. Eruption on that first album is when everybody was first blown away there, but a lot of great stuff throughout the catalog, even the most recent album, A Different Kind of Truth in 2012. A lot of great riffs and solos on that album. You might be surprised if you just missed it. I originally kind of dismissed it because the song Tattoo wasn't really a big fan of, and somehow that was all over the radio from the album. But besides that, a lot of good stuff on that album. Eddie just passed away, obviously, last week. Super sad. He was way too young, only 65, due to cancer. It freaking sucks, and it sucks even more that I never got to see him live. So gonna be super sad about that forever, but still got all that great, great studio material and some live albums to listen to by Van Halen. So Eddie Van Halen, gotta be my number one. Best hard rock guitar player of all time, without question. And that does wrap up my list. RIP Eddie Van Halen. Want to know what you guys thought about the list. Want to see your list in the comments. Till next time, thank you for watching.